When it comes to safety critical software for applications like aerospace, AdaCore is definitely on your list of suppliers for compilers in C, C++, and of course Ada. But now they're also turning their eyes towards Rust. To find out more, I spoke to José Ruiz. José, it's great to see you here at the AdaCore stand. It's Embedded World 2025. Now, AdaCore's well known for the Ada language, but maybe you can give us a quick introduction to all of the components of that and some of the other languages you support as well.
Yes, so yeah, as you know, I mean, AdaCore, we have been in the safety critical domain for 30 years already, helping our safety critical customers. Basically, what we provide is toolchains for Ada, C, C++, and our latest addition is Rust.
Yep. Super. And what sort of markets are you focused on? Who needs really safety critical systems? Automotive is one that springs to my mind immediately because I work in that space.
Sure.
What else requires that level of criticality?
Yeah, our main domains is aerospace and defense, also with some railway, some medical devices. This is our main, the main places where we have customers,
Now obviously Rust is a big topic. We're seeing lots of suppliers starting with Rust. Microcontroller vendors and processor vendors are starting to support it as well. What are you seeing in the Rust space and how are you responding to that changing market need and this new language that's appeared?
Yeah. So our customers are coming to ask about Rust, obviously, because it's a very trendy topic, and we are trying to figure out with them how to make Rust usable in the safety critical domain. It is the one that we understand. We are not trying to target the global Rust market. That's not us.
Yeah.
It's safety critical Rust that we want to try to address. Yeah.
And what are the fundamental aspects of the Rust language that sort of make it maybe an improvement over previous languages in that domain? What's the advantage there?
I think there is the obvious answer is memory safety. Mm-hmm. This is the key point behind every Rust argument is what does that bring with respect to C, C++ is memory safety. You prevent, you remove statically many of the memory vulnerabilities that are potential in your code,
And in terms of being a tool provider as well, is it just a case of certifying a Rust compiler and that part of it's done for everybody, or is there more to it than that?
So for us it's a challenging thing because you need to qualify the compiler, you need to qualify the different libraries. You need to provide all the tooling around. They need to be able to check coding standards and to be able to check code coverage. So it's a challenge for us in terms of the new things that we need to provide and all the quality improvements that we need to introduce in our tooling.
Now, inherently, safety critical systems, they take a little while to develop and people spend a lot of time checking them before they're released. Obviously, we want to sit in an aeroplane that's safe. What's the market acceptance of Rust at the minute? Where are people? Are they starting to use it or are they just looking at it? What are you seeing?
Yeah, I would say that they are starting looking at it. There's a lot of people interested. There is a lot of interest. People really want to use it. But as you know, using a language or doing a safety critical development is a huge investment. So they are kind of waiting until they see all the different pieces are in place. For example, they need a coverage analysis tool. They are waiting until they see that exists. They are waiting until there is vendors, qualifying compilers, libraries. So we see a lot of people interested. They are hesitant to be the first doing that. But things are moving. Moving slowly, but moving, and I think that is something that will happen relatively soon.
Now we're already seeing some safety qualified compilers on the market for Rust, targeting something like automotive.
Right.
And in that, my understanding is for safety critical applications, that's enough. I take a safety qualified compiler and I'm almost done. But in aerospace, that's not the case, is it? You can't just say I'm using a qualified compiler. How is aerospace and defense and those spaces different?
The approach within aerospace is avionics mainly is a bit different. What you need to certify is the whole system. And when I talk whole system, is the complete plane. So they need to go into the different pieces, down to the underlying compilers, underlying runtime libraries. So it's a very exhaustive work, and we work with our customers so that we provide the underlying pieces, certified pieces, so that they can use it in their whole development.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's a process that takes time, a lot of effort, but
one of the nice things, but I imagine also a challenge for you with Rust is the crates.
Yes.
The language, as it were, the language environment brings some software modules, such as, let's say, an SPI interface or something that can be reused. How are you going to tackle that? I guess that needs to be qualified as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so crates in Rust, it's a good thing. It's a very good thing because you have access to many different kinds of libraries processing, but you can't use any crate as you wish.
Yep.
You need to qualify it, you need to verify that it does what it needs to do. So yeah, our approach is to work together with our customers so we understand the crates that they want to use, that they understand that using a crate comes with a cost. For example, sometimes you use a crate, but that crate depends on a few others.
Yeah.
So you need to go looking into everything that is being used at the end. And it comes with a lot of work behind. So we are working together with them to understand what they need and what we can do together so that we qualify the different crates that they need.
Now, if someone's developing a safety critical product or project for the first time and they're new to all those processes, I've worked in the past with a medical company, for example, a startup, and they're sort of finding their way. Can you provide any consultancy and guidance as they negotiate all of those requirements and qualifications and certification processes?
Yes, so that's the kind of things that we are doing now with Rust, because everything is new. In the Rust world, certification is new. We are trying to leverage on our expertise certifying in avionics, space, railway, and all that. We are trying to work with them, telling them, okay, if you want to certify your code, you need to do this and that. And we tell them that we can help them, for example, providing them code coverage analysis tool, coding standard checkers. So yeah, we are working hand in hand with our customers, trying to define what we need to do, what they need to do, and how we can work together to do that.
Yeah. It's a fascinating topic. It's really interesting to see AdaCore embracing Rust and doing all the work there as well to make it usable in that space.
Yep.
Thanks for providing us an update on that.
Thank you very much.